Welcome to Engineers Academy. Subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to receive the notification for the upcoming videos. Now we are going to solve this sample problem 212. So it is from 3D moment and couple topic. So in this problem it is said that the turnbuckle is tightened until the tension in cable AB is 2.4 kN. Right, so this is the turnbuckle and the tension, the magnitude of the tension in this AB is 2.4 kN, right? So the tension magnitude is 2.4 kN, right? And it is said they determine the moment about point O of the cable force acting on point A. So we need to determine the moment of this tension force about this point O, right? And it is also said that find the magnitude of that moment as well, right? So now what we will do is that we will use this formula, right? So I will write that moment about O will be equal to ROA cross F, or I can say that cross T, right? So this is the tension, so I will write tension, right? So now for this, what we will do is that first we will find that tension vector, right? We are only given the magnitude, and the point A and B are given, which are on the line of action of this tension vector, right? So first what we will do is that we will find the coordinates of that A and B to find the T vector. So if I write the T vector is equal to, so it will be T magnitude, and this will be the unit vector from A to B, right? And this is the tension vector from A to B, right? And this is equal to T magnitude, and this is AB vector divided by AB magnitude, right? So first what we will do, we will find the coordinates of point A and B. So what are the coordinates of point A from this origin? So to reach this point A, we will travel how much? So we will travel 1.6 meter along x, right? So I will write 1.6, and then there is no need to travel along y, as this point A is in the xz plane. So we need to travel 2 meter along z, right? So I will write 0, and this is 2. And now what will be the coordinates of point B from this origin? So to reach this point B, we will travel how much? So this will be 1.6 plus 0.8, right? So this is 1.6 plus 0.8. So as a whole, we need to travel 2.4 meters along x, right? So I will write 2.4. And along y, we need to travel 1.5 meters. So I will write plus 1.5. This is 2.4, right? And since this point B is in the xy plane, so there is no need to travel in the z direction. So this will become 0, right? So these are the coordinates of point A and B. So now we can find AB vector. So AB vector will be equal to, so we will subtract the coordinates of A from B. So 2.4 minus 1.6. So again, we will be left with 0.8, right? So 2.4 minus 1.6. So I can write 2.4 minus 1.6 I plus 1.5 minus 0 J and plus 0 minus 2 K, right? So it will be 0.8 I plus 1.5 J minus 2 K. And what will be AB magnitude? So AB magnitude will be equal to, so this will be 0.8 squared plus 1.5 squared plus minus 2 squared under the root 2. So this will give us the magnitude. So let me find this magnitude. So this is the magnitude of AB, right? 2.625 in meters, and this will also be in meters, remember, right? So now what we will do is that we will find the T vector. So T vector will be equal to T magnitude. So T magnitude is 2.4 kN multiply by this vector. So it will be 0.8 I plus 1.5 J minus 2 K divided by this magnitude, so 2.625, or we can write it like this. So I can write it here, so 2.625, and we will remove this, right? So T vector is equal to, if I solve this, if I multiply this fraction with all of these components, so this will be the T vector. So when we solve this, so we get this t vector, right? So this is the t vector which is required in this formula, right? So this is this is equation number one, right? So now to use this equation, we need to find that our OA, that is the moment arm of this t vector from point O, right? And this is that vector ROA. So we can find that ROA if we know the coordinates of this A and this origin. So the coordinates of origin are 0, 0 and 0. And the coordinates of A are known, right? So it is 1.6, 0 and 2, right? So we can directly write ROA in terms of these coordinates, right? So it will be 1.6i plus 0j plus 2k, right? So this is our OA vector. So now we can find the moment about O using these two vectors, right? So that will be 1.6i plus 2k cross the t vector, and the t vector is 0.731i plus 1.37j minus 1.829k, right? So we will write it like this. So this will be I j, let me write it like this, so j and this is k, right? So 1.6, 0 and 2, 0.731, 1.371 and minus 1.829. To find moment, I will hide this first row and first column, and we will take determinant of this, right? So I will write that moment about O, and we will write minus 1 as well. So minus 1, and we will take the power of this minus 1. So this is the first row and first column element. So we will write 1 plus 1, and then we will take determinant of this, right? So the determinant of this is what? So this is 0 into this, so this will become 0, and this will be 2 into 1.371, right? And this will be the I term, this will be the I component of the moment, right, along the x. So it is 2 into 1.37. then again I will write plus and minus 1, and we will hide this second row, first row and second column, right? This is again 1.6, so we will hide this and this, right? So this is the first row and second column. So I will write 1 plus 2 and multiply by the determinant of this. So it is 1.6 into this minus 1.829 and minus this, so 2 into 0.731. so 2 into 0.731, and this will be multiplied with j, right? And then I will write plus, and again I will write minus 1, and now we will hide the first row and third column, right? So we will hide this. So this will be 1 plus 3, right? So, and this will be multiplied with the determinant of this. So it will be 1.6 into 1.371, and this will become 0, right? So this will be multiplied with k. So now we will be using this cross product again and again. So if we remember, so this will be plus 1, right? If I write, so here we will use plus 1, minus 1, and again this will be plus 1, right? And if we want to multiply this, if we want to find determinant for by using this row, so then this is the second row and first column, so then this will become minus 1. So then we will multiply minus 1 if we want to find the determinant by this element, by this row, right? So minus 1, this will become plus, and this is minus, and again if this is the third row and first column, so it will be plus, minus 1 and plus 1, right? So we can use these directly. So now our concern will be with these three first row, right? So plus, minus and plus. So with j we will always write minus. So if I simplify this, so this will be moment about O, and again this will become plus 1, right? So this is plus 1 into this 2 into 1.371 i. again this will become minus, right? So minus, and 1.6 into the same this thing, right? So this will be j, and this again minus 1 to the power 4, so it will become plus 1, right? So this is plus 1 into this thing. So we can remember this in case of the cross product, plus 1, minus 1 and plus 1. So plus 1, minus 1 and plus 1 with the k term, right? So now if I find this, so if I solve this, so we will get the moment about O. So we will get this moment vector, and this will be in kilonewton meters, right? So this is minus 2.74 plus 4.39 and 2.19 k, right? So now this is the, we have used this cross product and we have used this our OA as a moment arm. Now if we choose another vector, another moment arm vector, so that will give us the same result as well, right? So now let's suppose if I select this as a moment arm, if I select this vector as a moment arm, let's suppose if this is our OB, right? So this will also give us the same result. Now if this our OB is the moment arm, so then moment about O will be equal to, so then this will be our OB vector, right? So how to find that our OB vector? So for that we need to have the coordinates of this point B. So we already have the coordinates of this point B, which we have already determined. These are the coordinates. So it is 2.4, 1.5 and 0. So now to write that vector our OB, so we can write it directly in terms of these coordinates, as O is the origin, right? So we can write 2.4i plus 1.5j plus 0k, right? So now we can write directly here, so MO is equal to 2.4i plus 1.5j, and now if we take the cross product of these two vectors, so we will get that same moment, right? So let me find that moment. So it will be R cross F, so it will be equal to I, J and K, and 2.4 and 1.5, right, and 0, and 0.731, 1.371 and minus 1.829. So moment about O due to this T vector will be equal to, so this will be equal to, so I will write I, and plus 1 into, and we will hide this and we will take the determinant of this, so it will be 1.5 into minus 1.829 I, and now we will hide this column and we will take the determinant of these, right? And this time we will write minus 1. For this j we will write minus 1. We will multiply this determinant with minus 1, right? So minus 1, and this will be 2.4 into minus 1.829 minus, and this will become 0, right? So we will write, this will become the j term, right? And similarly for k, we will hide third column, and then, and we will write plus 1. And this will be 2.4 into 1.31 and minus 0.731 into 1.5 k, right? So when we solve this, so we will get that same moment about O. So this is that same moment that we have got for that our OA vector, right? So there will be no difference in the moment vector, right? So this is that same moment vector. So now we can conclude that the moment arm could be any vector from the axis of rotation to any point on the line of axis of this vector, right? So this could be also a moment vector. Let's suppose if I draw it like this, so this could also be a moment vector, right? And we can take infinite many moment vector from this point O to any point on the line of action of this T vector, right? Now in this problem you are also required to find the magnitude of this moment. So what will be the magnitude? So the magnitude of moment about O, so we will find the magnitude of this, right? So it will be 2.74 squared plus 4.38 squared plus 2.19 squared under the root. Right? So this will give us the moment, the magnitude of the moment about O. So this comes out to be 5.62 kilonewton meter, right? And we should write the units here as well. So it is in kilonewton meter.